Hello, dear viewers. Welcome to GeoNotes Daily Series, where we see how fast can we make something cool in Geometry Notes. And today, in the third and final part of this project on the clock, we will finish this by making the broken brick wall and the glass. If you want to see how the geometry for the body and the watch hand were made, check the other two videos. And also check the link in the top right corner for the video of the shader, making of the shader project. Also, if you want, you can download this project file from Gumroad for €2. And this way you get this cool project to play with and use it in your projects, and also support this channel. You can support the channel by also liking, subscribing, commenting to the videos, and that will make it grow as well. And thank you very much for doing this. Anyway, that is the introductory and boring part. I want to tell you in a few words why these videos could be useful for you. Because not only you get to see some interesting graphics, but you get to see how you can problem solve something to advance your work. For example, in the first part where I made these watch handles that are also animated and everything, I got to find the answer to question is like, can I use Geometry Notes to sculpt something? Yes, as you can see, you get some nice results. Or how can I recreate an analog movement? What's the math behind it? Also very interesting to observe that part. So for us, the second one, for example, the one here, the questions like how can you distribute evenly spacers like these ones, and how can you make them look interesting, have a nice shape to it, and that's something that you can use in many projects. Or for example, how can you add these Roman numerals? You have multiple instances, but you want them to be distributed evenly and in packs. Like we have three instances here, but only one here. How can I make three instances go here and one instance go here and two instances to go here? Very interesting. How can you make a cog-like animation? You can see it here. It's also moving in all sorts of directions. So a lot of answers that a lot of questions that get answered by making this stuff. But enough about the boring part. Like I said, today we will look at two things: the broken wall and also the glass. And the glass is an interesting one. I'm gonna start making it. Let me activate the screencast keys. But before long, you will have to ask yourself a question. How can I use this in my project? What can I do with this? So let's make this GN Geometry Notes clock crystal. And I'm gonna copy this name to the Geometry Notes modifier as well. So let's delete this one. Add a frame for this one. I'm gonna make it lighter so we can see everything that is inside. And I'm gonna start building the simple part, the dome on the center that go on top of the watch. And that's gonna be very interesting to see because of the technique that I use. I'm not gonna make just one things just one way. I'm gonna make it multiple ways so you get more tools to play with. So let's start with an icosphere, and I'm gonna connect it here, and I want more resolution for this one, something like this. And now I'm gonna plug delete geometry and go from there by deleting part of the geometry. I have a cough. Sorry, I'm trying to restrain as much as I can. but I'm sorry about that. So I want to build a mask to restrict the effect of this node. And the mask I want to be built on position, and I'm gonna use a vector separate, not combine, separate XYZ. Plug this one here, and I want to separate things based on the Z axis, this axis here. So I'm gonna use a compare node. Float is just fine, plug it here, and then plug this one to the mask to see something, and immediately we see this. But let's switch to less than because I want the other half, and we already see something happening here. And then you can play and decide just how much of the dome you want. So let's say like something like this. It's good to put it in context. So if we activate the body watch, we can see just how much we want to get from this one. So let me make it smaller by adding a transform node and plug it here afterwards. And I want to decrease its size till it's kind of fitting something like this. So basically like this. And of course you have to put it down, maybe something like this, until it kind of fits nicely into the picture. Something like this. If we get close, yeah, it's kind of stuck to the right place. So that will be one way of doing this. Like I said, there are many ways, but this is very interesting. Building a mask and deleting geometry based on position. I want to build the second one here, and I kind of want it to follow this curvature. And I also want to play with the splines to see, to answer this question. Can you shape a spline like we did here with this cylinder that it's composing this shape? That's an interesting question to get answered with. And why I decided to make this separately is because it's easy to add a solidify modifier if you want and give some thickness to this glass. So let's build the other part. But before building it, I kind of want to shade everything smooth. Okay, so if we switch to solid, let me close the body for now. You'll see the difference. Okay, nice and smooth. And for this one, I'm gonna start, like I said, with a curve circle. Alt P because I want this in this frame. Okay, great. And I want to turn this to a mesh. But let's combine it with this one so we can see it. Plug this one here, and we see something here. Let's bring back the body. I think this should be kind of smaller. So let's make it approximately, switching to wireframe, something like something like this. Yeah, kind of at the edge of this one, because we will go outwards with this one as we start to build a profile for it. So switching back to normal view and closing the watch, we have this shape here. I want to increase the resolution because if I'm gonna sculpt this shape, I'm gonna need more resolution. And also it's good to have more resolution if you want to add a custom UV map, and I'm gonna add a custom UV map for this, I know. So let's do now a curve to mesh. Plug this one here. And for the profile, I'm going to use a Bezier segment because, like I said, I want to do something else than just having a simple line. So let me close this one for now so we can see only this shape. Because if we use, for example, just a curved line, we get something like this. Very flat, boring surface. That's not what I want. So with the Bezier curve, you can sculpt things to your liking. And I'm going to increase this resolution also for two reasons, to have more points to work with and to prepare things for an UV, custom UV map. And let's put everything to zero and we start to build the shape now. So I want to move the starting point a little bit. And we see something like this. And I want to also move it on the y-axis. And we see starting to have a profile. So let's see what happens when we start to play with the handles of this one. But before playing with the handles, let's add an end point. So let's see, where do we want this to end? Let's do something like this, maybe. Let's see the watch here and switch to material preview. So now this one not having a material gives us a nice indicator of where things are going. So we want this to be pushed inside of this one. Let's see, in the wireframe mode, it's kind of like going here. So we can play with this later on. And I also want to push it a little bit down. Something like this maybe. So now we get this shape that you see here. It may not look correct. Sorry about coughing. But as soon as we start to play with the handles, so let's see what happens when we play with the handles of this one. We can push things around. And also move it a little bit here. And let's play with this one. And with this one. So we get something like this. As you can see, we have a lip here. Let me close this geometry. We have a lip here that goes nicely on this one. And also this, it's kind of having a slope like this to follow the geometry of this one. So as soon as we, as soon as we copy this node, transform and plug it here and reset it, we can play with our own transform for this one and bring it down to fit to our needs. So let's do it something like this. Let's see how it fits. I think I want it a little bit higher. Something like this maybe. And we see it's not exactly conforming to our shape. So let's play a little bit with this to close it a little bit. And then maybe pushing it a little bit up. Something like this. And then we can play with the handles of this one to push it down and then push it up again here a little bit. And then we can make it like a little bit smaller here. and push it down. It's just a matter of tweaking stuff and getting the result that you want. Now let's make it a little bit smaller here. Something like this starts to conform to this shape. So now we have we have the glass kind of done. This one, it's like a dome here. If you don't like it because it's so bulged, you can just play with the values and then bring it up again and unbulge it and bring it up again until you get kind of the shape you want. So something like this, let's say. It kind of looks nice. Okay, now let's get to the second part for this. This was building the crystal. Now let's see about this, putting all the pieces together. And for this, I'm gonna use another node tree. So let me save this project. So let's add a single vert, and I'm gonna call this GN clock master, whatever. You can put whatever name you want. I have a naming convention. I'm not bothering with it right now. So I don't want the input for this one, but I want to bring on this object that we created. And doing like this, you can have a different modifier on them, and then you can do different stuff with them. So I'm gonna connect these three together. It's important to make sure that these are not used as instances, because I found out that for glass especially, you get really big problems as soon as you do this. So the clock hands don't look very good. They kind of look a little on the big side. So let's do a transform on them and make things like a lot smaller. Where is my hands here? So not the crystal, but the hands I want to connect here. Let me deactivate the glass for a moment to see what's going on. Yeah, the handles looks good now. So this is it basically, but you can also rearrange stuff now, like bringing the hands down if you find the need, or pushing the glass up and that sort of things. But this is it basically. We have the clock master. So let's do another this is not what I wanted. I wanted a mesh single vert, add single vert, and let's do the wall. GN wall. So that would be this point, create the wall. So let's do the brick wall now. Okay, I'm gonna copy this and paste it here. So saving the project. And a quick word how you can approach this. So you want to build a brick of walls. Okay, that's made of walls, bricks. I'm not gonna bother making an offset for them, because that would be an entirely different thing. I kind of want it to be like put it together like that. So you have to find a way to instance a brick, to create a brick with details on it, and then to find a way to instance it on something that looks like a wall. So let's start with the first part. So let's create a brick, and we will actually create more than one brick. We will create three type of bricks, as you can see here, and they will all start from a simple cube. Okay, so this is how you can do this. We will sculpt this one a little bit, so let's add more geometry to it, plug it here so we can see what's going on, doing a frame and making that frame lighter. And let's see, how can we do this? We want to do a deformation on it, so let's do a set position. And for this, I'm gonna use a texture, noise texture, to deform this brick. And I'm also going to use it on different axes. So let's plug this one here for the X, for example. And because I don't want to start with a cube like this, let's make this a little bit like this and make it a little bit longer. So we have a deformation on X, and this is kind of too much. So let's add a multiply node, and decrease this strength quite a bit. Let's say something like this, maybe. That's gonna be good for now. So let's duplicate this two times and plug it for the Y and for the Z as well. And then we can play with the settings. This one, it's looking nice. This one, let's make it more influential and also decrease the scale a little bit. And I think I want to activate the cavity so we can see what's going on here, and also add a mesh set shade smooth, plug it here. Okay, and for the third one, I kind of want it to be very small. This is the face that we will actually see. I want it to be less big, this texture, the one that gives us this deformation. So let's say something like this, and then we will need something to make this a little bit smaller, because when we will instance it, it's gonna look maybe too big. So I'm gonna make it like a lot smaller. And this way we can control the different bricks easily, because like I said, we will have more than a brick. In yesterday video, I showed you how you can make an instance out of this, because I wanted to have not mesh, but instance for this to be easily manipulated. But since then we got this nice node geometry to instance. So plugging it here, we turn this mesh into an instance. So that's exactly what we need. That beautiful node, it's great. So now what we want to do, this was a simple brick. I want to duplicate this entire thing and do something else with it. So let's do Shift D. I kind of lost my node here. Let's bring it up a little bit. This one, let's bring it down. And let's look at this one, that it's looking exactly the same so far. Of course, we can play with these values a little bit to make it kind of different. But I'm gonna do something more interesting on this as well. not just playing with these values. You will see in a minute what I want to do. Now I'm just exaggerating these features here and maybe play a little bit with the values here. That in itself is giving us something different. But after I made this brick here, before turning it into an instance, I'm gonna basically add some cracks to it. So let's do a delete geometry, plug it here, and for cracks, a good texture to use is the Voronoi texture. So I'm gonna use that one, and I'm gonna switch it to 2D. We don't need 3D, and I'm gonna use this distance to edge. And now the very, very useful compare node. Float is just fine, plug the distance here. Let's switch this one to equal, leave it this on zero. Let's see what happens when we plug this one here and look at the top view. Let's play a little bit with this epsilon value. And now we see our cracked brick, something like this, maybe 0.01. I want to reduce that gap, 0.05, 0.008, something like this. Not too much. I think 0.01, it's I don't want them to start connecting. Something like this looks nice. So now we have a cracked brick. That's awesome. And now I want to do something else. So let me duplicate this setup again. This one, the original one. Shift D and put it here. And of course, I want to connect it to this node here to see what's going on. So let's select these two, Shift F to replace the connection. Back to square one, sort of speak. So let's play with these values a little bit to give it something else. I'm also going to increase this and also playing with this value as well. So maybe something like this, decrease this one. Maybe something like this. And then again, before creating an instance, I want to do something here to break the brick. And for this, I'm going to use something else. I'm going to do a set position. And now I will use a mask grave texture. So let's do mask grave texture. And we will rough up a corner from this one. Okay, let's see, combine XYZ, plug this one to the offset, and then I'm gonna plug this one into the height. We get this craziness happening. So let's add a math, switch this one to multiply and reduce the strength quite a bit. Maybe something like this. And then I want to increase the scale quite a bit as well. So maybe something like this. And let's see, how can we turn this into something useful? Because right now it's kind of not useful. Okay, Alt P, I don't want this to be in the frame. Well, I'm gonna plug a vector math here, and also switch this one to scale. And now we have a controller for this effect. So we will build a mask for this. How do we want to build a mask? We want to isolate a part of the brick. That means we want to play with the position. So let's add the position here, and I'm gonna do vector math, and I'm gonna also introduce a vector here, a simple input. So let's connect this one with this one, and I want the distance between these two. Excellent. So now that we have this distance, we can use this map range node, plug this one here, and we get a fall off basically. So let's plug this one, because using this boolean is giving you an on off value. That's not exactly what I want. I'd want a sharp cut here. I just want to have a gradual cut, so that's looking more natural. So that's why I use this setup. So now let's decide on a corner that we want to influence and on a range. So I want 0 to 1 to inverse the range here, and I want to decrease the fall off. That means the surface that is affected. And we see the rough up corner is kind of here. That's not what I want. I want to move it. That's why we have this vector here. So let's kind of move it to the side, something like this. And I want to move it like to the corner here, and kind of something like that, let's say. And I want to add a little bit of transforms to this, to squash this a little bit. So let's do something like this. Maybe something like this. And now it's just a matter of playing a little bit with these values that you see here. Let's see what happens if we do something like this. Increase the range here. And let's take a look at this, kind of looking like that. So maybe playing a little bit with this till I get something that looks better in my eyes. So let me see, pushing this more to the corner, something like this. Now it's looking kind of, but this is just fiddling with the values now. -0.01, I think it's gonna be better. So now we have kind of like a rough corner. So you get the idea. You can play with the values until you get the effect that you want. But I think it's time to get to this point, create the actual wall. So how we are going to instance everything on what? Well, let's start with the grid. So now we have three different instances here, and you can actually use only one node of this, Alt P, and connect everything, because this is kind of like a join geometry. So let's connect this one here, delete this one, and delete this one, and connect this one here. So now we have three instances here. And after that, let's do instance on points. This will be our instances. And we want some points. And if you want a wall, well, a good place to start is a grid. You can use this grid to create your wall. So let me connect this one here and see what happens. Well, let's add like 5 by 5 for now, and then we start to play with these sizes to get something working until it gets a little bit of gap. And the same here. And in the end, I just leave it, left it like this. You can do an offset of the roads by one brick. Of course, you can build a mask for this one. or do other crazy stuff like set position afterwards and use the indexes to move it around. I want to show you something else. I kind of wanted to do something different, not a classic brick wall, because as you saw in the demo, this is kind of like planked. You have something in between here looking. I call it the mortar. So being a small wall with something on top didn't matter too much. So I want to show you how you can randomize this and choose different instances here. If we use the pick instance, for example, we immediately see this distribution. But I want to have sub control. I want just a few roughed up bricks and broken bricks. I want most of them to be normal. So how will we do this? Well, we will play with the instance index, and for that I'm gonna use an utilities random value and switch this one to integer. And let's say we have three bricks, so that would mean 0 to 2 as an index, and I can plug it here, and immediately I see a randomization. But I want control over the first instance. It's important the order they are plugged here. And the first index instance is the simple one. So I want some control over this. And the way to get the control of this one, I'm gonna do a multiplication, taking advantage of the fact that first index has the value 0. So if I do a multiplication, everything that is multiplied by 0 is going to be 0. And the instance with the index 0 is the clean one. So now if I control this value, I can control how often the value appear. And that means I can use another random value and switch this one to Boolean, because Boolean is basically 0 and 1, true and false. So that means if I multiply everything by 1, I get the original result. It's kind of like not having this node. If I multiply with 0, I get the first instance. So this one, it's gonna do this, will randomly decide if we use the output of this one or the brick with index 0, the clean one. And that probability will control this. If you want less of the broken one, and as you go here, you get more up to the result of this one. So this is how you can control this. And of course, you can play with the seed here, and you can play with the seed here until you get something that kind of looks like you want. And that's how you can build a simple controlled randomized effect, where you decide how much randomization have you from one instance and to the next. I also want to do something to basically add more, take more advantage of what we did here, meaning I want to reuse this because they are kind of, everything it's the same direction. But if you rotate it, you kind of get like different result, because this part is gonna be here, so it's gonna look different. And the same goes for the roughed up corner. You can make it appear maybe here, or maybe here, or maybe here, and that's gonna give you more mileage out of this setup. You'll get more variation without actually doing more work. So let me take this frame, and I'm gonna plug it here, and we will continue. So I want to add a random rotation a little bit. First, I want to make this look like a little bit more rundown. So let's do another random value and switch this one to vector and plug it to the rotation, and everything goes crazy. So let's do like a very small value. Let's say minus 0.03, and 0.03 here. So now I get a little bit of randomization, a little bit, to add more interest to this wall. but not too much. And I want to do the same for the scale. So let's duplicate this node, tag space to reset it. And I'm going to plug this on to the scale. And the scale, I'm going to randomize, but quite a, just a small amount, something like this. And now we have a little bit more room for bricks to rotate, and we see more space between them. If it's too much, you can adjust it here by decreasing these values. But I'm going to leave it like this. I'm not going to do live tweaking. As you can see, that can get boring and kind of long. And now I want to do this, to rotate these bricks, but in a fixed increment, in the random fashion. So let's do that. That's going to be fun. Rotate instances, plug this one here. And if we want to do a random, we're going to need a random node. But I want to rotate only one axis, this one. Because if you rotate on the other axis, you're going to get very weird results. So I'm going to just do a vector, combine XYZ, plug this one here into the rotation. And now we can add a random value and plug it here in the Z. And the random value that we want, it's going to be 360 degrees. That's going to be in radian 6.2. So you can type tau, and that's going to give you that. But this is completely random. I want random rotation, but in certain increments. So let's increment that into 180 degrees increment. So let's do a snap on the pi. That's going to be 180 degrees, meaning half of this value. So now, as you can see, sometimes the corner is going to be here, sometimes it's going to be here. Sometimes this one is going to be here. Well, let's play with the seed. Yeah. Now, sometimes the corner is here, but sometimes it's here. And sometimes it's here. Well, we only have two rotation with this. But things looks nice. That's kind of the point of doing procedural stuff. Now you can get a lot of variation just by playing with some values here. Excellent. I wanted to add something else to this. That was the mortar that you see between the textures in the bricks in the demo. And for that, I just added this cube. Not cone, cube. And then a geometry, join geometry, plug this one here, plug this one here, and then just play with the settings. I want like very small thickness for this one, and then I want to match it in size to the wall that I created. So maybe something like this and something like this. So now it looks like it's not a brick wall, but something that it's put on top of a concrete wall. And that was the look for, that I was going for. So this is kind of the thing. You can add a set position to this one, so you can move it a little bit down to give more depth to these bricks. Well, not that much down. Maybe like 0.2, something like that. Let's leave it like this. So this is how you would do that look that I was going for. Awesome. Now I'm going to show you the cleanup version of this project. So you can take screenshots. And that will conclude this series of tutorials. So this is the cleanup project file. This is how the end result looks like. It's kind of looking like rundown bricks. And I'm going to do full screen. This is the brick wall that we created. This is the simple brick if you want to see the final values. And this is going to be the cracked version. And this is going to be the broken corner version. And as you can see, this is brick to instance, or you can use the new node that is doing the same thing, instance on the line. I leave it because it's a nice workaround. And then the way we created the wall here, the grid, this is controlling how often the simple brick appears and how often the other bricks will come up. And this is the rotation and scale control. A little bit of variation on the scale, a little bit of variation on rotation. And then we do the flip on the z-axis to get more variation, and the mortar that was built here. Of course, we added the materials, as you can see here. And I'm going to show you the crystal material that we created here. So let me show you this one. Come on. Okay. So this is the glass center. These are the final transforms that I did. And this is the rim with the final transforms that I did. I also did, on top of what I showed you, this spline parameter factor, and capture the attribute for the mesh and the profile to get this custom UV map that is plugged here with this name on the point domain. And this is what I use in the shader for shading this part. So that was gonna be all for this project. Thank you very much for watching. If you want to support this channel, if you think it has value, like, subscribe, comment to the videos, or check the Gumroad page and maybe purchase something from there. That will help this channel grow. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and happy blending.